Hello, this is Professor Zaman. Welcome to Hasan Zaman educational video series. Today's video is in our DC circuit series. So today's topic will be series parallel circuits or series parallel networks. So this topic is in continuation with our previous topics where we dealt with either only series circuits or parallel circuits. In today's circuits, we will have both structures, series and parallel combination of resistors. But again, what will remain same is that in these circuits that we will be talking today about, we will always have only one source, one voltage source. Because when you have multiple voltage sources, it becomes more difficult to solve those circuits. Actually, later on, we'll learn techniques to solve circuits with multiple sources. Again, we will restrict our discussion to voltage sources only. I should mention at this point, there is another kind of source called current source. And we'll discuss that in a later video, which is not complicated at all, but we most often use voltage sources. That's why we'll keep our discussion confined to voltage sources only. Okay, let's begin. But before I begin, I would like to tell you one thing. Since in this topic, we'll discuss circuits starting from very simple circuits to a little more complicated circuits. Because the purpose is, at this time, we want to be familiar with or get used to dealing with little complicated circuits. If you can master these things, the circuits we will be discussing, hopefully you will be in a solid footing to solving DC circuits, series parallel circuits with ease. If you feel a little overwhelmed at some point, just take a break and come back, then watch the rest of the video. Okay, let's begin then. DC series parallel circuits. So let's begin with a very simple circuit. Let's have a voltage source first. Let's have one resistor, and we have two resistors here. Let's also add a ground node. So let's assume this is 12 volt. This is 2 ohm, this is 2 ohm, this is 2 ohm. So if you want to solve this circuit, as we know, we have to find the currents and voltages at every point or branch of the circuit. The general technique of solving a DC series parallel circuit is actually to reduce the circuit or minimize the circuit to just one resistor. And as I said before, in this topic, we'll only discuss circuits with one source. Our goal will be to reduce this part of the circuit into just one resistor. Then we can apply Ohm's law to find the current through the battery, or we also call it source current. Then we can find out currents in other branches. So first step is minimization. After we will be done with minimization and we will find the source current, then we will actually go back or expand the circuit back to the original shape So we can find the currents in branches that we have reduced in the first place. That the second step will be expanding it back, or expansion. Okay. So let's do the minimization first. And this is where you have to have some practice. Which should we minimize first? You have to remember, we can only minimize a set of resistors only if they have two terminals. You cannot minimize circuits or resistors which have more than two terminals. So in this case, I guess you have correctly guessed, the thing to minimize here would be these two resistors. And I think you have also understood from the structure of these two branches, they are in parallel, okay? Because they have the same voltage across them, but after when the current comes here, it will be divided into two branches. So if you minimize these two resistors, what will be the new resistor value here? Equivalent resistor. We found that in our previous parallel circuit topic, that if you have two equal resistors, or even any numbers of equal resistors, the combined resistance value is, take one of the value and divide by the number of branches. Here we have two branches and the value is 2 ohm. So 2 ohm by 2, the combined value is only 1 ohm. So if I redraw this circuit, this is 2 ohm, one thing I probably didn't mention before, for a voltage source, the bigger line, you see there are two lines parallel, the bigger line is always the positive side of the voltage source. So even if I don't draw the plus or minus, you can understand that the positive is on the top, on the bigger side, and negative on the smaller line side. But for clarity, we are drawing the plus and minus here. Okay, so we found out the value of this resistance is 1 ohm. So now this circuit has become much simpler. The structure of this circuit tells us this is a series circuit. I think you have also understood this. And what is the total resistance of this circuit? You can assume this is a two-terminal network, because it is actually. If you break here, then you will have two terminals. So you can combine these two. And the combined resistance will be 2 plus 1, 3 ohm. So I can draw another version of it, that is with just one resistor. Volt plus minus 2 plus 1 is 3 ohm. This is the simplest form of the circuit. That means we have completed our minimization. Now we can apply Ohm's law and find the current. We will be dividing 12 volt by 3 ohm, not because the source voltage is 12 volt, but because this source voltage is solely being dropped by this 3 ohm. So the voltage across this resistance is also 12 volt. That's why we are dividing 12 volt by 3 ohm. If there are another resistor, we couldn't say the whole 12 volt would be dropped across this resistor. 12 volt, so the current will be, using Ohm's law, 12 by 3 ohm. And we have to now do the expansion, or go back this way, so we can find other voltages and currents. We have found only the source current, which is current through the battery. We will also have to find current through these branches and other voltages. Before we do that, I would like to point out another thing. Remember, we found the combined resistance of these two resistors, and I mentioned you can only combine resistors only if they have two terminals. To elaborate on this topic, suppose if you wanted to combine these two resistors, we couldn't do this because they do not have two terminals. What would be the structure in that case? We will have two terminals here, but we have to remove this. So if you remove this, you have two terminals here, four terminals. And it may look like these two are in series now, but they are not, because we cannot really reduce this circuit this way because of this having more than two terminals. The reason I mentioned this here, this may come in future again. And because of this reason, when you solve a series parallel circuit, try to combine resistance from the farthest end from the voltage source. In this case, these two are farthest from the voltage source, and usually you will be safe doing that, and you will be dealing with only a combination of resistors having only two terminals. So let's put back the original structure. Okay, now we will go back and find the other parameters. So current here is 4 ampere, we already found that. And what is the voltage in this resistor? We can use Ohm's law, current is flowing this way, so it will be plus on this side, minus on this side, and the voltage drop will be I times R. V is equal to I times R. I is 4 ampere, R is 2 ohm, 4 times 2, 8 volt. So it will cause a voltage drop of 8 volt. That means the voltage here will be 12 volt minus 8 volt, it will have 4 volt. But for now we will not do that, because that actually comes from Kirchhoff's voltage law, which we have not really discussed in detail in this series. So we will refrain from using KVL or Kirchhoff's voltage law. We will just leave it like this, okay? And we will come here. Here we can put that this is 8 volt and this current is 4 ampere. So now the question is, what is the current in these branches? When the 4 ampere current comes here, it sees two equal resistors, and we can prove this, but there is no reason to do that. This is common sense. The current will be equally divided. So the current here will be 4 by 2, 2 ampere, and here also 2 ampere. Now we can find the voltage across this using Ohm's law. 2 ampere current and 2 ohm resistor, so V is equal to IR, I times R, 2 times 2 will be 4 volt. So this voltage will be 4 volt. Using KVL or Kirchhoff's voltage law, we would have found also 4 volt. Now the question is, what is the voltage here? If you remember what we discussed in our parallel circuit video, parallel branches always have same voltage. So you don't have to calculate 2 times 2, 4 volt. Since this is 4 volt, this has to be 4 volt. So now we have solved this circuit completely. We found voltages and currents everywhere. So this is the simplest case of series parallel circuit. There are more things to discuss in this topic. I hope you will continue to watch our next videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.